Hello, future doctors. Today, I'm going to discuss a few things about NTA 2019. That is, as we all know that NEET UG 2019 exam will be conducted by National Testing Academy, NTA, from 2019. In this video, I'll be discussing about the deleted syllabus from NCERT for 2019 NEET exam, the least important chapters for NEET exam, and portions which can be skipped for NEET 2019 exam. And this video is brought to you by aim4aims/neet, and I'm Dr. Ajay Mohan. I completed my MBBS from AIMS Delhi. All the information that I'm going to give is given in the official website of NTA, that is www.nta.ac.in, and also in the MCI, Medical Council of India official website, www.mciindia.org. So let's see what are the deleted syllabus from NCERT. So from the plus one chapter of chemistry, from unit one, some basic concepts of chemistry, the historical approach to particle nature of matter is actually deleted. So there's no need to study that part. And unit two, structure of atom. This is the point of confusion for many students. The discovery of electron, proton, neutron, Thomson's model and its limitations, Rutherford's model and its limitations, Bohr's model and its limitation has been deleted already. So there is no need to mug up those data. Just leave those portions if you are aiming for NEET exam. Though these portions are important for other exam like AIMS, but this is totally deleted from the syllabus for NTA 2019/NEET 2019 UG exam. And unit 3, classification of elements and periodicity in properties. In that, brief history, that is names of scientists, what was the discovery, year of discovery, everything has been deleted from the syllabus. Significance of classification is deleted. Development of periodic table is deleted. Inert gas radii is deleted. Nomenclature of elements with atomic number greater than 100. That is also deleted from the syllabus. And in unit 4 of class 11 chapter of chemistry, in chemical bonding and molecular structure, covalence nature of the ionic bond, that is actually a separate section given in that chapter, that is also less important, and that is also taken out of the syllabus. And in unit 6, thermodynamics. In thermodynamics part, which is the toughest portion of chemistry, physical chemistry, in that, concept of system, types of systems, surroundings, work, heat, energy, extensive and intensive properties, state functions, etc., all has been deleted from the syllabus. In unit 8, redox reactions, applications of redox reactions, which is given at the end of the chapter, is also deleted from the syllabus. In unit 9, hydrogen, which is a very important chapter for NEET and AIMS exam, in that part, position of hydrogen in the periodic table, hydrogen as a fuel. This, I guess, 1 to 2 paragraphs are given in NCERT. You can skip that. There's no need to learn that. In unit 10, from the inorganic part, S-block elements, alkali and alkaline earth metals, everything related to calcium oxide and calcium carbonate has been deleted from the syllabus. In unit 11, P-block element, that is inorganic part, P-block element, physical and chemical properties of boron has been deleted. In unit 13, hydrocarbons, classification of hydrocarbons and aliphatic hydrocarbons has been deleted. So I guess most of the tough part has been deleted, considering the fact that physics and chemistry are not that much to be tested in a medical entrance examination. More of biology or specifically zoology and botany should be tested. So these portions have been deleted from the physics and the chemistry part. So let's see class 12 chemistry. In class 12 chemistry, unit 1 in solid state, which is actually a nightmare for many students, the N and P semiconductors has been deleted from the syllabus from Unit 3 Electrochemistry, Nernst equation and its applications. And its applications to chemical cell has been deleted in Unit 7 P block elements. Group 15, Group 16, Group 17. In Group 15, nitrogen preparation, properties and its uses, compounds of nitrogen, that is also deleted. In Group 16, properties and manufacture of sulfuric acid is deleted from the syllabus. In Group 17, oxidation state, preparation of chlorine and hydrochloric acid. So H2SO4 and HCl, less important, deleted from the syllabus. In Unit 8 D and F block elements, occurrence of transition metals, metallic character of first row transition metals has been deleted. In Unit 9, coordination compounds, which was the most important part in last year's in AIMS exam, and from that chapter, extraction of metals is the only part that is deleted. Rest, all other important parts are important. Just extraction of metals has been deleted. So after this chemistry, let's see the physics part. What are the things that is less important and deleted syllabus part of physics? In class 11 physics, unit 7, properties of bulk matter, pressure due to fluid columns, Pascal's law and its applications, hydraulic lift, hydraulic brakes, effect of gravity of fluid pressure. In short, fluid mechanics. Is not at all important for NEET exam. For AIMS exam, this is still important, but for NEET exam, you can skip this part. There's no need to revise it before your NEET exam because this won't be tested in your main exam. In Unit 9, behavior of perfect gas and kinetic theory. Kinetic theory of gases, RMS speed, Avogadro's number. These two things has been deleted. The rest all things are important. So after plus one part of physics, let's see what are the deleted portions of plus two part of physics. Unit 10, communication systems, entire portion, I should specify it, entire portion of the syllabus of this unit is deleted. That is elements of communication system, bandwidth of signals, bandwidth of transmission medium, propagation of electromagnetic waves in the atmosphere, sky and space wave propagation, need for modulation, production and detection of an amplitude, modulated wave, etc. Everything, the whole chapter. So the whole chapter is deleted. Deleted from the NEET syllabus 2019. So this chapter won't be tested at all in your NEET exam, but still, considering the previous papers of AIMS exam, this will be very, very important, and you can even get image-based questions for your AIMS exam from this chapter, that is block diagrams, etc. But for your NEET exam, you can say that you can skip this chapter as a whole. I should say this specifically because I should be sorry to say that in my last video in NEET paper analysis, I mentioned that communication system was really important. I'm so sorry about the mistake, but I should say that I considered 20 years AIMS paper and 31 years NEET paper while making that important list of chapters that should be studied. So in AIMS exam, it was very important, have been asked multiple times. So accidentally, I included that in the NEET video. So please, I'm so sorry about it. I feel that I should apologize to all the viewers because that was a very big mistake from my part. So I should clarify it. And thanks to a couple of students who mentioned that mistake to me. And I wish that such mistakes won't be repeated. So communication system as a whole has been deleted from the syllabus for NEET exam. So before concluding the video, I should say a couple of things. Syllabus of NEET exam is not equal to aims. Those who are studying for aims should study all the chapters given in NCERT, and specifically importance should be given for last 20 years aims paper and 31 years NEET paper. 31 years NEET, or previously called AIPMT. 20 years aims paper. So the syllabus of NEET is not similar to aims. So fluid mechanics, which is actually deleted in the NEET paper, is actually really important for aims exam. So likewise, the chapter communications, which is very easy chapter, just study that single chapter from the NCERT part of physics, that is not at all important for NEET exam, but really, really important for aims exam. So that's all in this video. So I guess I cleared my part. I cleared the mistake that I did in the last video regarding the communication chapter. So I have discussed all the new additions and new deletions in the syllabus. So if you want more information, please go to the official website. All the data that I have taken has been taken directly from the website, official website of NTA, that is National Testing Academy and Medical Council of India. So I have already mentioned the website. Please go through it. And if you have any doubt, please drop your queries in the comment section. And also, if you like the video, please like and subscribe the channel. And if you like the video, please share it with your friends also. And I will try to make more videos to make your revision more easy. I am planning a set of videos which will help you in your last minute preparation. So stay tuned to Aim for Aims. Thank you.